So in this lecture we will discuss about moment of inertia. Actually moment of inertia is we can say that it plays the same role in rotatory motion as inertia plays in translatory motion. So as we know that inertia is the measure of motion, or you can say more precisely as translatory motion contained in a body. Similarly, moment of inertia is measure of rotational motion contained in a body. So now the basic mathematical equation of moment of inertia is MY is equals to MR square, where M is the mass of body, or we can say the equivalent or total mass of the body, and R is equals to its distance, or more precisely perpendicular distance from axis of rotation. Now if suppose there is a system of n number of masses, m1, m2, m3, m4, m5, m6, m7 up to mn, let's say, and we have to find its moment of inertia about this axis that is going inside the plane of paper. And suppose these are their displacement vectors from this origin, R2, R3, etc. So then moment of inertia I about this axis of rotation can be calculated as summation of moment of inertia of individual masses about that axis. So M1 R1 square, M2 R2 square, plus M3 R3 square, plus up to plus mn rn square. So we can say that I is equals to sigma mi ri square, where I is equals to 1 to n. So this is the basic equation for moment of inertia. Now we can have some standard moment of inertia, or some standard set that we generally encounter in our civil engineering problems. Like first of all, let us consider a rod of length L having its mass per unit length as small m, and if we have to find its moment of inertia about this axis passing through its CG, or we can say the center, such that this is L by 2 and this is L by 2, then first of all, as we know the basic definition of moment of inertia, that it is the product of mass into its distance from axis of rotation, that is the square of distance from axis of rotation. So if we define the moment of inertia of this small element having thickness dx at a distance of x from the axis of rotation, and its mass would be, mass per unit length is m, so m into dx, so mass per unit length into total length of the element. So that would be the mass of the total element multiplied by its distance from axis of rotation and square of that. So this is basically m r square and nothing more. So now if we want to find the moment of inertia of this entire rod, then we need to integrate it from limit minus l by 2 to l by 2, because we are considering this axis of rotation as origin. So the length of this element would vary from here, this remaining constant, minus L by 2. Suppose on this side it would go up to minus L by 2, and on this side it will go up to L by 2. So integrating dI over minus L by 2 to L by 2, here we can have it as m dx x square minus L by 2 to L by 2. Now writing it in mathematical terms, mx square dx minus L by 2 to L by 2, So integrating it would be m x cube by 3 minus l by 2 to l by 2. So that would give me m by 3 l cube by 8 minus of minus l cube by 8. So it will be equal to m by 3 into l cube by or l cube by 4. So m l cube by 12. But as we know that m is equals to mass per unit length. So if we want to get the total mass of the rod, it would be small mass, m mass per unit length multiplied by total length of the rod. So that would be equals to ml, capital M. So if I consider ml, l square by 12. So it would be ml square by 12. So this is the equation of moment of inertia of a rod about its central axis. So here you can see that moment of inertia is actually m, that is the its unit would be same as mr square, that is kg meter square. Now this 12, and we will always have some constant in the expression of moment of inertia of any term of any standard object. That is because of its geometry and its mass and everything. So basically it is simply mass multiplied by distance square.